Welcome back to another video. Unfortunately, this is another one I don't want to have to make. Things are getting real here. So you saw the title of the video. Unfortunately, it's not clickbait. This white Model 3 is officially bricked. I'm gonna see if there's anything I can do to bring it back, but let me explain real quick how I got to this point. So maybe you saw my previous video where I accidentally ran the car's battery down to 0%, made it to a supercharger and was able to make it home, but who's to say I didn't damage something in the battery system? So several days has passed since I ran the battery down. Didn't have any problems until last night. So I'm now getting a BMS alert on the screen. And anytime you get an alert that starts with the letters BMS, that's usually the battery management system. So there's something in that component system that is messed up, obviously. And so I looked up that code online. You can just take that code and Google it. You'll see some forums. You'll see other people, you know, getting that and what happened to theirs. Saw a guy that had a front inverter had to be replaced. Another guy, it was just a wiring harness. It could be a number of things. So let's go see what's going on currently with my car. So when I say my car is bricked, I mean this thing is properly bricked. No power at all. Can't even open the doors because, of course, they're electric. Now, if you were inside the car, there is an emergency pull latch that's attached to a cable that mechanically will open the door for you, but since I'm not there and I didn't have the foresight to roll a window down, here we are. So let's think this through for a minute. If my doors are locked, that's not controlled by the main high voltage battery that I ran down the other night. That's controlled by the 12 volt up front. So let's go get to that. So problem number one, to get to the 12 volt, you have to pop the frunk. To pop the frunk, you have to be able to unlock the door to get in there to turn on the screen to unlock the frunk for it to pop open, but I can't do that. So there is an emergency way to do this. Let me show you that technique real quick. There is an emergency access panel right here to pop your frunk. All you need is a 9-volt battery. I just happen to have one of these guys laying around. You don't need a long-lasting battery. You can get these at the dollar store. You can borrow it from one of your kids' toys. You just need it for just a second to pop the frunk open. Just as a side note, there is some security built into the cars in regards to popping frunks open like that. If the car is locked, the frunk will not pop open with a battery, and that's for security reasons if you store things in your frunk. Also, the frunk will pop open with this if the battery's completely run down and not working. And that's kind of the scenario I'm in right now, so this should work. To open up this little panel here, you just need to push on this upper corner. And if you need some extra leverage on the other side, you can use a plastic pry tool to just pop that open. Once you have the port open here, you just need to pull out your two cables. You've got one labeled red, the other one is black. This is your positive, this is your negative. So what you'll do is look on the side of your battery. There's your negative side, there's your positive side. So we're gonna put the positive to the positive and the negative to the negative, and let's see if this pops the frunk open. All right, so positive, like that, and negative. All right, so the 9-volt worked. You guys aren't gonna believe this, but that 9-volt battery, just popping the frunk open, unlocked the whole car. It's actually booting up now. 12-volt battery is going to be underneath this, and that's what you would need to either charge up or replace, something to that effect. But hey, I've got it up and running, so I'm going to go check this out. Okay, so that 9-volt battery gave it just enough power to kind of start everything up, but it just died again. So as you can see, it is locked, and I did leave the frunk open, but I also rolled down the window. So let's see if I can get this door to open with the emergency pull right here. Yeah. So there's just proof that if your car is completely dead and you're inside the car, you can use this emergency pull latch right here. All right, so there is obviously a problem with my 12-volt battery up front. I did not get any alerts in the car that tells me anything about needing to replace my low voltage or 12-volt battery. I know you've seen a lot of those alerts on the internet and people having to swap out their 12-volt battery. That's not the alert that I got, but something is causing that 12-volt battery to lose power. So could that be something in the battery management system? Could be something in the DC to DC converter that converts the high voltage into the low voltage. Keep in mind, electric cars do not have an alternator. Gas cars have a belt-driven alternator that keeps putting energy back into the 12-volt battery, and that's what runs the car. There are no belt-driven anything in an electric car, which is good because no belts that you need to replace. It's good for maintenance and things like that. So there is a DC to DC converter. I don't know if that's the issue, but there's something definitely that's keeping that from charging up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace this 12-volt battery. I've actually got a spare right here. I've got it on my battery charger here, and it is charged up. It's all green. So this is a battery. It is used, but it is a good battery. So, you know, I'll take this for right now and just see if we can install that and see if what the alarms are telling us now. And probably we'll still have to take this into Tesla and have them investigate. Good to see that my leaf guard is actually doing its job. So I'm assuming you guys already know how to replace the 12-volt batteries, just like a gas car. You undo both terminals. There is a breather tube. You just pull that out because this is a lead acid battery. It does put off gases. Then you need to unbolt this. You push this in and up, and then it comes out. This is just the tie down. It holds it in place so your battery doesn't rattle around. But then after that, you just grab this handle and pull it out and put in the new one. Okay, here's the moment of truth. I just put in the replacement battery, put down the positive terminal. Let's go ahead and connect this negative and see if this thing comes back to life. I heard some noises. All right, it looks like it is coming back. So let's see what the alarms are telling us now. All right, so I'm still getting some alarms here. Let's see what we can see. All right, so there is some troubleshooting steps in here. It does actually tell you a couple things. So let's see what we can find out in this owner's manual guide here. So something else we can look at, you press your menu here. Up here, you'll see these are alerts here. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So, all right, so now we're getting a slightly different BMS A151. I'll take a look and see what that is. This is new, that VC front. This is the original one I was getting, that BMS 035. So I need to go take a look and see what these are. You just Google these and, they can sometimes they'll tell you more about what it might be. This VC front, I don't know if that's like a voltage controller or something, but, we'll take a look. There's a couple other things we can look at. Let me show you next. All right. So if you go into your main menu here and go to software, hold down Model 3 for about 3 seconds,
And now you can type in the word service to go into service mode. Okay, it's just saying, are you sure? Yes. So now I'm in service mode. Let's take a look at a couple battery things here, and we'll see if there's anything that stands out. All right, so low voltage battery. Low voltage is actually looking good. It's the high voltage battery has a contactor state that's open. So a lot of these settings, you're going to need the tools that Tesla has, whether it be, you know, a laptop with their software that they run. So there are ways you can go in here, but let's just take a look at this high voltage system. So there is a fault on the high voltage battery. Don't see here. So contactors open. All right. So the power conversion system, the PCS. All right. So I'm going to exit service mode. You just press this button right here. So now I'm out of service mode. What I think I'm going to do next is a hard reset of the battery. So let me go ahead and do that, and we'll take another look at this. All right, to hard reset the battery, first you open up this back door because we're gonna have to disconnect the battery from underneath the seat on the passenger side. Then we can disconnect the negative on the 12 volt battery, reconnect it, and then reconnect this, and that resets everything. So to do this, there is a little latch on the front here. You just slide it over that way, and that'll pop this up to where you can now lift this part up. So to do this, you first remove this little foam piece, and then this, you pull this down and latch it down and pull it up. All right, I just did a hard reset of the battery. Still getting these same alarms here. Not anything different. So that's it. I've done about everything I can do personally to try to bring this back to life. And unfortunately, I'm gonna have to take it into Tesla and have them take a look to see what's damaged, what needs to be replaced. And hopefully it's not anything major, hopefully. So until I get that scheduled, I'm gonna leave the frunk open and also the window open here in case the battery dies completely again. So I was able to get the car started just enough to get it out of the garage and position it in an angle where a tow truck can come pick this thing up. I had just enough power to move the car out of the garage, but this is what I'm getting now. Something to take note of is make sure you roll your window down just a little bit here, because when that battery dies, this will not drop. And when you try to open the door, even if you're inside the car, it'll catch on this lip and you can crack your glass. So just make sure you've got that down a little bit. I've also popped the frunk here just in case we need to get to that tow hook there that connects to there. I don't know if that's how they're going to put it on the winch to pull it up on the flatbed or not. And of course, make sure you're able to put it into tow mode, and that way they'll be able to pull it up onto the flatbed without too much struggle. This is how you put in the tow hook here. You actually have to turn it counterclockwise to get it to go in. I thought that was kind of odd. This is where they store it right there. So you just put it in there. There's some a threaded hole in there, and you just start turning it counterclockwise, and that tightens it up.